What is biochar? And how does it work as an amendment for improving soil fertility in your garden? Let's find out. Biochar is created by heating organic materials like wood or crop waste in a controlled environment. This process transforms the material into a stable form of carbon that's rich in beneficial properties for soil health. The charring or pyrolyzing of the organic matter burns away almost everything and leaves behind the carbon, which is generally referred to as charcoal. Biochar is one grade of this charcoal, but other grades can offer some benefits in the garden as well, to a limited degree. Biochar improves both water and nutrient retention. It promotes beneficial microbes, can persist in the soil for hundreds, even thousands of years, and its benefits can be harnessed in large vegetable gardens as well as small container gardens alike. The term biochar was coined back in 2005 by a man named Peter Reed, but although the term is relatively new, using charcoal to improve soil fertility has been done for a long time. Located within the Amazon rainforest lies a hidden treasure that still supports flourishing gardens to this day. It's a type of ancient man-made soil that's rich in carbon and highly fertile, known as terra preta. That means black earth in the Portuguese language, from what I understand. It's a massive achievement and a testament to the ingenuity of the indigenous Amazonian civilizations who created it thousands of years ago. Now, biochar, or charcoal, is not generally considered a fertilizer, but it can be, depending on the material it's made from. Instead, it's considered more like a container that holds on to fertilizer and water, but then releases it to the plants when needed. It does this well, and as we'll see, it can do much more than that. Many of the benefits that come from biochar stem from its physical structure. Imagine it as a sponge, riddled with tiny openings, microscopic pores and channels. These pores act like small reservoirs, capturing and holding on to water after a good rain. During dry times, they slowly release the stored moisture, helping the plants to stay hydrated. This translates into reduced watering needs, saving time and resources while preventing your plants from wilting as fast as they otherwise would under the hot summer sun and stunting their growth. These pores also act as tiny storage compartments for essential plant nutrients: nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. Biochar attracts and holds them all within its structure, and many more, preventing them from leaching away with rain. But even though it holds on to and prevents these nutrients from simply washing away, it holds them loosely enough for plants to access when needed, creating a readily accessible nutrient supply. This combination of water retention and nutrient availability creates a powerful opportunity for the plants growing in our soil. With more water readily available, plants can utilize these nutrients to reach their full potential, leading to stronger root systems, improved growth, and increased resistance to pests and diseases. Another one of the numerous benefits for soil health biochar offers is its ability to provide shelter for microbes. Imagine a tiny city bustling with microbial life. Biochar's structure is similar to a high-rise apartment building for these microbes. Its porous nature creates a vast internal surface area with countless nooks and crannies, like tiny rooms and corridors. This provides a huge habitat for microbes to live and store their food. They can attach themselves to these intricate structures, forming dense communities and living out their vital roles in the soil ecosystem. Microorganisms are the ultimate recyclers. They break down dead leaves, twigs, and other organic debris, releasing essential nutrients back into the soil in the form that's readily available for plants to absorb and use for growth. They also act as natural disease fighters. Some beneficial bacteria and fungi can suppress harmful pathogens in the soil, protecting plants from potential threats. And here's another amazing thing. Microbial activity can actually promote plant growth. They produce various growth hormones and beneficial compounds that stimulate root development, enhance nutrient uptake, and even improve plant stress tolerance. So having a diverse, healthy microbial population is kind of like having a team of tiny assistants constantly working to ensure your plants flourish. Additionally, microbes also act as habitat protectors. They create a network of tiny channels and spaces in the soil, providing shelter and refuge for beneficial insects, worms, and other creatures that contribute to a healthy ecosystem. Biochar's ability to hold on to water is crucial for microbes, as they need a moist environment to survive and function optimally. During dry periods, biochar releases the stored water slowly, creating a stable and hospitable environment for these tiny organisms, even during challenging conditions. Furthermore, Biochar acts as a buffer, protecting microbes from harsh chemicals and pollutants that might be present in the soil. Things like fertilizers, herbicides, pH adjusters, and of course pesticides can disrupt the delicate balance of the soil ecosystem and seriously harm these beneficial microbes. Biochar's unique properties help to absorb and trap harmful chemicals, preventing them from reaching the microbes. This helps to ensure their survival so they can continue all of their vital tasks like nutrient cycling, disease suppression, and plant growth promotion, ultimately leading to a healthier, more productive garden. When we compare some of the other grades of charcoal with biochar, a large difference reveals itself in the form of porosity. While three types of charcoal, lump charcoal, biochar, and activated charcoal, share similar origins, their porosity, or the amount of empty space within them, differs significantly. This difference plays a crucial role in their respective uses. Let's start with lump charcoal, the kind you might use for grilling. While it still has many air pockets, the internal structure is not as extensive as other forms of charcoal, but it can work okay as a soil amendment. Biochar, on the other hand, boasts a significantly higher porosity compared to lump charcoal. Its production process creates a much more intricate network of pores and channels within its structure. This increased internal surface area is one of the main reasons why biochar is so beneficial for microbes when using it as a soil amendment. But when it comes to porosity, activated charcoal takes it to another level. This specifically treated charcoal undergoes a process that significantly increases its surface area, making it incredibly porous. In fact, just one teaspoon of activated charcoal can have a staggering 30,000 square feet of surface area. This immense surface area is why activated charcoal is primarily used for absorption, where it attracts and traps various molecules, making it valuable for filtration and purification applications. It's not typically recommended for use in soil directly, except maybe when trying to clean up or detoxify soil. Biochar remains the go-to choice when it comes to harnessing the power of charcoal for a thriving soil ecosystem. But biochar's benefits extend beyond just providing food storage, shelter, and water. It also plays an important role in aeration, helping to ensure enough oxygen is available for soil microbes as well as plant roots. Remember, even though they live underground, many beneficial microbes need oxygen to breathe and function effectively, just like us. Here's where biochar's porous structure comes into play yet again. The numerous pores and channels within the biochar can also act like tiny air pockets throughout the soil. These air pockets help trap air even in soggy conditions, just like perlite can do. Think of them like little air tanks for aerobic microbes during these periods of heavy rain or overwatering. The trapped air helps to ensure they have access to the oxygen they need to survive, even when the surrounding soil is saturated. Now let's talk about using biochar. It can be applied directly to the garden once inoculation is finished. It can also be added to a compost pile or a compost tumbler like this one, and the compost will charge the biochar as it decomposes. Liquid fertilizers work great as a relatively fast way to load up the charcoal with nutrients. After soaking it for 24 hours, or until fully saturated, it's then incorporated into my soil. I only use organic fertilizers because I want to promote microbial growth, and strong chemical fertilizers are often deadly for microbes. The fertilizer can be specifically tailored for the kind of plants that the biochar will be used with. I just mix the fertilizer with water as per the manufacturer's instructions. And of course, compost teas can work really well for inoculation, particularly aerated compost tea. I generally use a mix of about 5-10% biochar to soil. I'm not very precise with it. Much more can be used if desired. 20% is about the most I've used. Too much is wasteful, of course, but it can also be detrimental to your plants if overapplied. Some top dressing can be done without charging the biochar first, but a fine particle size would typically be recommended for that. Fine particles are able to slowly make their way down into the ground. The rain and soil, among other things, should inoculate the charcoal before it gets down into the root zone. Granular forms of this micronized biochar are sold to make applying it much easier and less dusty. This micronized product includes humic acid and is very convenient to broadcast onto gardens that have already been planted. And it works for lawns, trees, and shrubs also. I just follow the manufacturer's instructions and do my best to keep it off the plant leaves. Another way of adding fully loaded charcoal to the garden is by spreading a layer of it about a quarter to a half inch thick over the soil and then mulch over the top of it. The mulch will help keep it moist and feed the microbes as it decomposes. Mulch also helps to prevent the charcoal from washing away. As I show in other videos, which are linked below, charcoal can be made in the backyard fairly easily while at the same time enjoying an outdoor barbecue. For many, that may not be an option. However, good quality biochar is becoming increasingly available at garden centers and online retailers. So here are three things to keep in mind when selecting biochar. Number one is feedstock. This is basically the starting ingredient, or the material that gets heated up in a special chamber to convert it into biochar. Hardwood feedstocks can provide a lot of stable carbon, but other types of charcoal can provide some nutrients up front. Biochar companies will typically have their products analyzed by a lab. These lab reports will tell you important things about the biochar, like its pH level and nutrient content. The report should also show a low level of contaminants, like heavy metals. The size of the charcoal pieces is another consideration during selection. The ideal size depends on how one uses the biochar. Compost can be purchased that has biochar already added to it. One must evaluate the cost effectiveness of individual mixes, as they can vary quite a bit. Biochar breaks down very slowly, acting as a long-term source of carbon in the soil. This stable carbon source not only improves soil fertility by promoting the growth of beneficial microbes, but also contributes to better soil structure, enhancing drainage, aeration, and overall crop production potential for years and years to come. Another benefit is that it improves the cation exchange rate of the soil, which I'll talk more about in other videos. One more thing to keep in mind when buying biochar is what, if anything, the charcoal is mixed with. As I mentioned, some companies offer it combined with humic acid, compost, or fertilizer, which I think is great. But I don't purchase biochar that's been combined with harsh chemical fertilizers, as they could in theory harm the microorganisms that I'm trying to promote. Biochar can be a powerful tool for gardeners. If you're interested in biochar, or would like to learn more about how it can benefit your garden, check out the resources in the video description below. I'm pretty impressed with biochar. My experience with it in both indoor and outdoor gardens over the past couple years has been very positive. I'm looking forward to learning more about the subject and sharing what I discover. Thanks for watching.